Hey everyone, in this video I'll be explaining anti-roll bars. Now anti-roll bars are also called anti-sway bars or sway bars. Anti-roll bars are used to reduce body roll when cornering and also to change understeer or oversteer characteristics of your car. Now the reason you want to reduce body roll when cornering, other than the obvious reason of you don't want to roll over, is that you want to reduce the weight transfer to the outside tires in the corner. By having more even weight distribution on all your tires, you'll have better handling. So how does it work? Well, the anti-roll bar connects your suspension components. So you've got your control arms, which are connecting to your tire and also connect to your frame. And so you're going to connect both of these control arms together. So basically, you're going to connect these two independent suspension components. Now what happens is when this, say this tire hits a bump or some elevation change and it goes up, it'll turn this roll bar up. And so by turning that roll bar up, it's going to produce a torque along that bar, which is going to force the other side to move up as well. So think of it like my arm, and it connects. So here is going to be where my hand is going to be the connection with the suspension. As that pushes up, it's going to twist along my arm, transferring that force along. So as it gets to here, this point right here, it's going to want to move that section up with it, because it's stiff. And so as it pushes that up, it's trying to bring the tire up closer to the car, so that when you're in a corner here, it tries to bring that tire closer to the car and levels out the vehicle. So another thing it does is you can change your slip angles by installing these anti-roll bars. And by changing your slip angles, you can reduce your understeer or you can reduce your oversteer. So what you want to do is, if you're trying to reduce the understeer of your car, you can either install a rear sway bar or increase the stiffness of the sway bar that is already there by getting either a stiffer sway bar, or perhaps it's an adjustable one. Or you can remove the front sway bar or decrease the stiffness of the front sway bar, or get a less stiff sway bar for the front. Now, if you're trying to reduce oversteer, you're going to do the opposite. You're going to install a front sway bar or increase the stiffness of the front sway bar, or remove the rear sway bar or reduce the stiffness of the sway bar. Now, removing it probably isn't the best option. You probably want to reduce the stiffness or increase the stiffness first, rather than just take something out and see how that affects the handling. But this is the methodology you should use if you're trying to reduce understeer or reduce oversteer and increase the handling of your vehicle. So you can see here the anti-roll bar on the back of my 99 Integra, and so it goes across. There's a bushing there so that it can't go, the roll bar can't move up, but it can only twist, and then that passes along to the other suspension side, and it'll connect in the same manner it connects right here. And so as that goes up, it'll twist this, and as it twists, it'll force the other tire to want to move upwards and level out the car.